Okay, good morning students. Today we are going to learn one writing skill, that is analytical paragraph. Already we have learned many letters. Last year we have learned about article writing, how to write an article. So it is analytical paragraph which we have learned in class 6-7th. How to write information by given one of the chart, one of the data which is given. So on that basis we have to write certain factual information, that is called analytical paragraph. So if you see analytical paragraph, there will be three sections in that. First one is introduction, second one is body of the paragraph, and third one is conclusion. So here introduction means what is given in that we have to explain in a very brief manner. It should not be lengthy, it should be very as compact as possible. Second one, body of the paragraph means what is given in that graph, maybe chart, maybe some maps. So that you have to write in a very factual manner. Whatever given in that properly and within short words we have to write. And then what exactly this total graph said, that we have to write in a conclusion. Okay, that is called analytical paragraph. So we have to analyze this, and according to your analysis you have to write the information in the three paragraph, that is introduction, the second one is body of the paragraph, and second last one is conclusion. So we'll see that. So analytical paragraph writing is an descriptive writing which is written on the basis of the given chart, graph, data, outline, clues, table, the best possible manner, and add to cover the information provided. That is called a analytical paragraph. Understood? So the analytical paragraph has to be written in around 100 to 120 words. So it will come for 5 marks. Got it? Okay, this time we have one letter and one analytical paragraph. It replaced story writing. First we have to write story, right? Na? We used to write story. But right now we have to write analytical paragraph. This is very, very important for your future perspective. Because when you will go, give more exam, when you will go in foreign countries, at that time this will be very, very helpful. This will check your skill. Okay, analyzing skill means how you analyze anything, how you properly brief, how you will understand, comprehend anything, and you will write your own information. So that will be helpful. Okay, we will see what are the features of the analytical paragraph writing. So it describes the given chart, table, data, graph. What will it describe? It will describe in your own words. Okay, this is a pictorial information, you know, graphical information. Suppose graph is given, table is given, and you would write in a words that. Okay, so it describes the given chart, table, data, graph, or clues, etc. Second thing, it should be brief and comprehensive. It should not be that too lengthy. So we have to write exact information about the given clues, given table, given chart, given map. We have to write exact words so that everyone will understand very quickly. The third one is, it should be state facts and that are provided by the chart. We should not write else information which we know. What you know, that is not that important in this writing. So whatever is given in this paragraph, in this chart, table, that you have to write. You have to stick to the information which is given there. You should not write what you know, what you have heard, what you have seen. That should not be written in this analytical paragraph. Then it is necessary to make use of simple and accurate language. Why simple and accurate language? Because one should understand very quickly. Okay, as language will be very simple, we can comprehend it very easily. If it is very difficult, we will fail to understand it. And what will be our aim? Our aim will be that the person who is going to read the information must get what? Must get understand, right? Now that whatever you have written, that should be understood very quickly to the reader. Then it is appropriate to use the same tense throughout the analytical paragraph. Okay, then last one, no personal observation or response should be provided. As I told you earlier, that we should not write whatever you have listened, whatever you have seen, or whatever you have heard. It should not be a personal type of writing. It is totally factual type of writing. Whatever is given, that you have to analyze, that you have to understand, comprehend, and then you have to write in a very limited words. That is called analytical paragraph. Okay, it would be preferable to use the passive form of the verb. Why passive form of the verb? Because in passive voice, what we do? We focus on object rather than subject. Okay, so here what will happen? Suppose we will be passive voice, what will happen? We'll understand the main concept very quickly. We will focus on the object, we will focus on the process. Fine, so we will be objective while learning. So we have to use, if possible, passive construction. So what we have to understand, it describes, we have to describe here given chart, data, table, anything else. Then it should be brief and comprehensive, it should not be too lengthy. Then it should state facts that are provided by the chart, table, graph or map that we have to understand. It is necessary to make use of simple and accurate language. Again, I repeat, why? Because one should understand very quickly. Otherwise, you will use very difficult words. What will happen? No one will understand. Okay, this is your explanation regarding this chart. So that your explanation should be very accurate and very simple to understand. Means what will be the motto of reader or speaker? Whatever I will speak, that should be reached to the public or audience who is going to listen me. And he must understand it without any complications. So we have to use very simple and accurate language. Got it? Then it should be mentioned figure and quantities appropriately. Whatever is given here, that only we have to write there. We should not write, okay, I feel that it is wrong and so I will write this particular figure or number. No, that is not allowed here. So what is given here, that particular figure, that particular quantity should be mentioned. Even though maybe it may happen that during CBSE exam you might get certain different figure about the population, and you might have read somewhere that the population of the Kerala is that particular that number, and in the question paper you might have got something different. So you will see your conscience will say no, it is wrong. But at that time what you have to do, whatever is given in the question, that only we have to write. Getting everybody? Then no personal observation or response should be recorded there, no, because whatever is given, that should be written. And it would be preferable to use passive form. That these are the very keen guideline to write the analytical paragraph. Got it? Then next, there are three. If we see about the format, there will be three sections. First one is introduction, second body of the paragraph, and third one is conclusion. What you have concluded, what you have summarized, that should be in the conclusion. Introduction, what exactly is given here, what is the paragraph is about. For example, question is given, the graph is given, shows estimated sales of gold in Dubai in 2002. Totally in 2002, it is not given many years, only one year, that is 2002. So in that 2002, there will be January to December, all 12 months. And in that 12 months, what is the sale of gold that is given, that we have to properly compare month to month, and we have to write approximately figure of that sale. Getting everyone? Then second, body of the paragraph, that there will be explanation of your sale. What is the sale between January 2002 to December 2002? That explanation will be recorded in your writing, or it will be written in your body of the paragraph. Got it? And third one is summarize. Means what exactly, what happened throughout the year for the sale of gold in Dubai, that summarize you have to write, that conclusion you have to write in the last paragraph. Okay? So we will see. So introduction, explain in one or two lines the subject of the graph. What is the aim of the graph should be written in an introduction. in one or two line. It should not be four, five lines. It should be we have to stick with the one or two line. The second, body explains in detail that what the graph is about, use relevant figures, explain trends, make comparison and contrast, divide into sub paragraph if required. If you want to explain different concept about the same graph, you can go with the second paragraph as well. It is not that you have to write only three paragraph. First one introduction, second body of the paragraph, and third one is conclusion. No. If you have many concept in middle, you can make another paragraph also. Okay, that will be better understanding. Then third one is conclude the paragraph, giving the overall view of or summary of the graph. Okay, so we have understood what are the basic guidelines for the writing analytical paragraph. Second, what we have understood format of the analytical paragraph. In format, we have seen introduction will be very brief. Second, the body of the paragraph will be explaining whole given input. And third one is conclusion. In that, we have to write what we have to write? Summary. Whatever we have studied, that summary we have to write in the conclusion. Isn't it very easy? Surely very easy, because you are very, very smart, clever. So you have understood it. Fine. Now we'll go in detail what exactly we have to write in the introduction, what we have to write exactly in the middle body of the paragraph and conclusion. And then we will see one example and we will stop this. Fine. So we will go with the introduction. The introduction is the first paragraph that should describe in brief what the graph is about. We have to understand here what we write here. The introduction of the graph. This, what is the, what information is given about the graph, that should be written in a very brief manner. Okay. It should be like an opening paragraph that introduces the reader to the context of the chart given. When writing the introductory paragraph, you need not go into the details. Only introduction, only main aim of the paragraph should be written there. Should not go in detail, because in detail where we'll go? We'll go in detail in the middle of the paragraph, that is body of the paragraph. There we'll go in a properly in detail. Properly quantity we will put there, we will put the number, we'll put the statistic there. But in the first paragraph, we will introduce what exactly given in the question. What exactly the paragraph is about. That we will write in the introduction. You just need to mention what is clearly evident from the chart or the graph given in the question. That only will be in the first paragraph. And that will provide you one mark. Very easy. It is very easy to write down the aim of the paragraph. Okay. In second, the body of the paragraph we will see in detail. It is much lengthy, we will understand. This part of the analytical paragraph should contain details of the graph chart given in the question. Details, totally. Means here, you have to write in a such a way so that not a single confusion will be there in the minds of the reader. Got it? It should be as much clear you can write. Okay. So it is extremely important to choose the significant details that should be included in the paragraph so that you can give proper justification to the paragraph. Understood? The body can be broken into two or three sub paragraphs depending on the information extracted from the graph. Suppose it is big one, concepts are big, then you can make it in a three paragraph. If it is very short, we can make it in a one paragraph. Depend upon the body of the paragraph. Okay. So what we have to do, breaking the body into sub paragraphs makes it very easy for reader to understand. Why we are going to break the paragraph? Because we will, what we will do in a separate paragraph, we will make separate concept so that reader will understand very quickly. In that, first organizing the information. First one, organize, means we have to collect the information which is given in the graph, table or map. So in that, what we will do, we should look for the large differences that are very prominent. means first we have to see large differences, what exactly given in a large manner. Then second with minute also we have to see. But we should not miss a single word. We should not miss a single concept from the given input. Okay. You can mention the aspect which is smallest or the largest in the data given. Any aspect that are similar should be mentioned next. So first we have to write down the main, then sub, then sub. Okay. You should further mention about the aspect that has remained unchanged or constant throughout the year. For example, what is drastic change in that? So in the month of July or August, there is a drastic change, or there was a great sale of the good. For example, I haven't seen it here. That should be mentioned in the first. Second, little change. Then, for example, month of August, September were constant. That can be written. Then second, comparing information. Suppose we will compare here. In the month of January, the sale of gold was more than the month of December. So we can compare. Contrast also, in the month of January, the sale was very high. On the other hand, in the month of June, sale was very low. Contrast, comparison that can be done according to data provided. Then next, if in the chart mention two different parties, for example, men, women, we can write down that, boys, girls, result of the this year and that year, okay, color, or we can say games, selection in the game, some in the mid 20 or 2000, we can see that some know, some loves football, some loves cricket, how many? That can be, or population also we can see, literacy rate also we can see. So comparison will be there in literacy rate. For example, literacy rate in Maharashtra and Kerala. There will be comparison, given data will be different. So in the year 2000, for example, so and so, the literacy rate of Kerala will be was higher, and at the same time in Maharashtra it was lower. We can compare data in this analytical paragraph. Okay, so understood comparing information. So if the chart mentioned two different parties, for example, men, women, refer to both of them in the analytical paragraph. We should not write only the positive trait. We have to give the justification both of them. What is given? Men, women, two state, two countries, two aspect. We have to give proper weightage for both of them. Got it? What exactly you do here? If there is any contrast or comparison that should be drawn, you must present it very effectively. You have to present it very effectively so that one can understand it very quickly. Got it? You must present effectively. If the chart is about a particular time period or highlights trend of several years, mention each year in a concise manner, in a brief manner. Then if any comparison or contrast can be done for two or more years, you should write about it too. So what exactly we will do here, even though comparison is there or contrast is there, we should not miss it. Okay. Then last one, mentioning quantities. For example, sale of gold in Dubai in 2002 February is, for example, 12 lakh, okay, in October 50 lakh. So write down the mention the figure there exactly by comparing, contrasting. Understood everyone? We can contrast now. Then when including number and figure, their accuracy must be ensured. I feel that I have written. No. What is given here in the chart? That millions of the dirhams. Okay. This is the currency of the Dubai. So that this is the currency, and here months are given. And in the January 2002. So in January we can see here 200 dinars. Then February it is around 225. That should be written exactly. There are number of ways that can be used to describe quantities. For example, percentage wise we can write, fraction wise you have learned fraction in mathematics, 1/2, 1/4, we can use this, right? Na 1/4, 1/2, 1/3, we can write double, thrice, 4 times, we can write, right? Na in this way also we can write, or ratio also, 1:2, 1:4, that also we can write. But you have to write in a proper way and with a accurate way. The last one, collecting sentences. If different information or ideas are there, you should use connectors or linking phrases. Different, on the other hand, meanwhile, like that we can use. So connecting sentences should be, connecting words should be used, connecting phrases should be used here. Okay, and last one we will see about the conclusion. What is the conclusion? Summary of the written data. What exactly I have understood throughout the chart, that should be write in a brief manner, again brief manner, but it will be more than your introductory paragraph. Okay, so we'll see here, the last paragraph should summarize the idea mentioned and the information in the general. It should be concluding the in nature and act as a closing statement. So here we have to close the writing. So most probably you have to write here in a closing way. One should keep in mind that one must not include any personal opinions, conclusion or observations. Again, I repeat that personal responses is not allowed here. Whatever given, that only we have to summarize. Okay. You should simply stick with the facts. So you need not dispose of the information to write a good analytical paragraph. The key to choose wisely the important information, organize it well, state correct facts and summarize it properly. So we have to stick with the correct information here and to the point, as it is given for 5 marks. Okay, so in that, in middle you have to explain well in a brief way, because you have to write within 100 to 150 words. As you complete your later writing, like that you have to complete this analytical paragraph writing as well. Got it? So what we have learned? We have learned that guidelines for the analytical paragraph. Second one, we have learned about the format, introduction, body of the paragraph, and last one is conclusion. In that introduction, we have learned what exactly the paragraph is about, that we have to write in the introductory paragraph. It should be as brief as possible. Then here, body of the paragraph should be explained very neatly, clearly, accurately, without any personal response. Whatever given, that only we have to write. And conclusion means what? We have to write, we have to summary of that whatever we have written. Okay, one example you will see. Already I have stuck one photo of the graph, Dubai is good. So example is, the graph given shows estimated sale of gold in Dubai in 2002. Write an analytical paragraph describing the line graph in the around 150 words. So here, gold, Dubai gold sale 2002, that is the title of that. The line graph depicts the estimated sale of gold in Dubai in 2002. That will be the introductory line. What is given here in this paragraph, in this graph? Estimated sale of gold in Dubai in 2002. That we have to write. In one sentence, we can understand, we can explain it. What is the paragraph about? Dubai gold sale in Dubai in 2002. That is about the paragraph. Now, in the second paragraph, what we will write? How sale was gone throughout the year. Got it? Of gold in Dubai. You will see that in January 2002, the sale stood at 200 million dirhams. 200 million. Here, millions of the dirhams, okay? Dirham is the currency of the Dubai, you know very well, right? लाइक अवर इन इंडिया रुपया, राइट राइट ना, रुपया ना कि पैसे, रुपया रुपीज वी से, डॉलर रुपीज लाइक दैट. सो इन जनवरी सेल वॉज 200 मिलियन दिरहम्स. ओके एट स्टूड 200 मिलियन दिरहम्स. इट स्टेडीली इंक्रीज थ्रू द नेक्स्ट मंथ एंड पिक टू 350 मिलियन दिरहम्स. सो वी कैन सी दैट इन जनवरी इट वॉज 200 मिलियन, देन इट इज इंक्रीज स्टेडीली, नॉट एग्जैक्टली इट पिक्ड अप, नो स्टेडीली स्लोली स्लोली इट इज इंक्रीज, राइट. एंड इन मार्च इट इंक्रीज टू 350 मिलियन. We can write like that. So here comparison, right? Na January, February steadily increase. They have written here increase, but how steadily? Drastically? No. In March it drastically did increase. Then April we can see it comes down. Right? In April it comes down to again 250. Then May it has come down again 2 million. Then June again. Around 150, July 125 million. So the sale of the gold in Dubai decreases as month goes away, right? That we can understand. So however, the gold sale started to plummet over the next 3 months and hit 110 million dirhams in the month of July. It comes down to 110 million. In the January month of January, it was 200 million. Then it steadily increasing. In the March, it goes to 350 million. Again, it started coming down. And in the month of July, it totally collapsed to 110 million dirhams. Okay. Unexpectedly, the sales doubled in August before coming down to the same level. Again here, and in August we can see it went up, the sale increase in the month of August 2002 in Dubai. Here where it is around 220, we can count it out, okay, or around 210 we can say. For the next 2 months of the year, the gold sale leveled off 180 million, and then slightly increase in the December. That is what the explanation about the graph in middle. So introduction was what? In the given chart, the sale of gold in Dubai in 2002 is described. In meanwhile, in the second paragraph, what we have explained the total sale from the month of January 2002 to December 2002. Now we have to write the summary of that conclusion. So here overall the estimated gold sales fluctuated in 2002. Fluctuation is there surely, because first it was steady, then again it has reached to high peak, then come down again up. So fluctuation was there, it was not steady throughout the year. Then afterward again 180 million, it was then it was again steady, right? Now September, October, November, December, it was little steady, not exactly, but little up and down was there, but it was quite steady. So there was fluctuation in the, of the sale of the gold in Dubai in 2002 throughout the year, that we can say, right? Conclusion line, the sales were highest in the month of March and the lowest in the month of July and September. The sales at the end of the year were almost the same as they were in the beginning of the year. Sales were 200 million at the beginning of the year, means January, and at the end of the year also slightly, means around 190 million or 198 million. It was almost same. That we can write in the conclusion. So it is very easy to write down the analytical paragraph. Got it? Very easy. Because why? Because in the first line, introduction line, what we have to write? What exactly paragraph about? Second, we have to properly explain in the middle, in the body of the paragraph. in that accurate information should be written. Suppose quantity is given or number is given, we have to write it properly, the number and quantity. And in conclusion, what exactly we have explained in the second paragraph, that we have to write in a proper way, we have to summarize that. Okay, in a brief manner, we should not write like a body of the paragraph in the conclusion. It should be short, more than introductory paragraph, but less than main body of the paragraph. Okay, got it? I hope that you have understood this analytical paragraph. We will see more examples of the same in our revision time. Thank you. Thank you very much.